And finally, I note that when only the value function is assumed, our protocol has a polynomial round. But if we assume the existence of a collision resistance hash function instead, then I can reduce the round complexity to logarithmic. And this logarithmic round complexity is essentially optimal because our protocol is proven secure by a black box simulation. And for black box concurrent zero knowledge, it is known that logarithmic round complexity is required. All right, so this is a summary, so I will give more detail. And I start by recalling the zero knowledge protocol. So as everyone knows, zero knowledge protocol is a two-party protocol between approver and verifier, in which the prover proves the correctness of a statement without giving any additional knowledge to the verifier. And this zero knowledge property is formalized by using a simulation paradigm. So a protocol is said to be zero knowledge if for any verifier there is a simulator such that it can output a simulated view of the verifier that is computationally indistinguishable from the real view of the verifier. And one of the most popular research direction on zero knowledge is to achieve a stronger notion of zero knowledgeness. And in previous work, there are many notions of zero knowledgeness were proposed and studied. And in this work, I focus on statistical zero knowledge and concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. So statistical zero knowledge is a notion of zero knowledge that guarantees that the adversary's view can be statistically simulated. So it in particular guarantees that after the protocol is executed, the witness remains secret forever. So it's strong. And also, although it is very strong, statistical zero knowledge is known, it was shown that the statistical zero knowledge can be constructed from a welfare function. And in fact, it was shown that the statistical hiding commitment can be constructed from welfare function. And so we can obtain statistical zero knowledge from welfare function by simply using this statistical hiding commitment. And next, concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge is a zero knowledge process, is a notion of zero knowledge that provides security against adversary that interact with multiple prover and verifier simultaneously. So in particular, it provides concurrent zero knowledgeness and non-malleable zero knowledgeness. So it provides security against coordinate attack. In which the adversary attack a prover by interacting with many provers simultaneously, and also it provides a security against man-in-the-middle attack, in which the adversary attack a verifier by interacting with the prover simultaneously. And like statistical zero knowledge, concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge is also known to be constructible from one-way functions. And in particular, Barak, Probe, Hacker, and Sahai show that concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge argument can be constructed from welfare function. And Ling, Pass, Zeng, and Mutz show that concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge proof can be constructed from welfare functions. Then, since both statistical zero knowledge and concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge are useful strong security notion. A natural question to ask is, of course, whether we can have both simultaneously. Or in other words, whether we can have statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. So statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge provides security in the concurrent setting in a very, very strong sense. So it's of course good if we can have quick achieve this security notion. But since it is very strong, it's a very hard task to achieve statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. And in last year, in a beautiful work by Orlandi, Ostrowski, Rao, Sahai, and Visconti, it was shown that the answer of this question is yes. And in particular, they show that the statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge argument can be constructed under the DDH assumption. Then, given the result of Orlandi et al., the next natural question to ask is, of course, whether we can have statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge from one-way functions. So in other words, since we have statistical zero knowledge and concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge from one-way function, but we have statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge only from DDH assumption, there's a clear gap. And so the question is whether we can close this gap. And in this work, I studied this problem and showed that the answer of this question is yes. So this is a statement of my result. So I show that the polynomial round statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge argument for NP can be constructed under the existence of one-way functions. And I know that if we assume the existence of a collision resistance hash function, then I can reduce the random complexity to logarithmic. But because of the lack of time, in this talk, I ignore the random complexity from now. So from now, I concentrate on how to construct statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge argument from one-way function. All right, so let's go to the technical detail. And I first give the definition of statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. So roughly speaking, statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge is a notion of zero knowledge that guarantees that the proof that adversary receives from the prover in the left interaction do not help the adversary to generate a proof in the right interaction. So in other words, it roughly guarantees that if the adversary can prove a statement in the right interaction while receiving a proof in the left interaction, then the adversary could prove the same statement even without receiving proof in the left interaction. So it essentially says that the left proof is useless for adversary. And formally, statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge is defined by requiring that for any mind-the-middle adversary, there is a simulator such that it can statistically simulate adversary's view. And in addition, at the same time, the simulator can extract witnesses for all statements proven by the adversary in the simulated view of the adversary. So note that if we have such a simulator, we can not only obtain simulated view of the adversary, but also prove the same statement as adversary by using extracted witnesses. So the existence of such a simulator guarantees the security I sketched in the previous slide. So this is the definition of statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. And next, before explaining my own protocol, I first explain the difficulty of constructing a statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge from one-way function. And to explain this, I explain why previous computational concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge cannot be a statistical one, and why previous statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge requires a DDH assumption. So first, very, very roughly speaking, previous computational concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge were designed in this way. So first, the verifier commits secret trapdoor information by using a commitment scheme called concurrently extractable commitment scheme. And after that, the prover commits to a witness by using a non-malleable commitment scheme. And then The prover gave a witness indistinguishable proof of knowledge, proving that X is in L, and a witness for it is committed to in the non-malleable commitment, or trapdoor information is committed to in the non-malleable commitment. And of course, a honest prover proved this statement by using a witness for the first conditions. And roughly speaking, in this scheme, concurrently extractable commitment scheme enables a concurrent simulation. So in particular, since the values committed to by the concurrently extractable commitment can be extracted even in the concurrent setting by rewinding, the simulator can simulate adversary's view by simply extracting trapdoor information from a concurrently extractable commitment scheme and giving witness indistinguishable proof of knowledge by using extracted trapdoor information. And also, very, very roughly speaking, non-malleable commitment enables a witness extraction. So we have to show that the simulator can extract witness from the adversary even in the simulated view of the adversary. And the non-malleable commitment guarantees that even in the simulated view of the adversary, it commits to the witness in the right session. So the simulator can obtain witness by simply extracting committed value of the non-malleable commitment. So in this way, this scheme is a computational concurrent non-malleable knowledge. But unfortunately, this scheme is inherently computational concurrent non-malleable knowledge. And it cannot be a statistical one. And the reason for this is that in this scheme, the prover commits to a witness by using a non-malleable commitment scheme. And this non-malleable commitment scheme is only computationally hiding by definition. So since the simulator doesn't know the witness, it has to commit to another value in non-malleable commitment. And so the simulated view is only computationally indistinguishable from the real view of the adversary. So this is the reason why previous computational concurrent non-malleable knowledge cannot be statistical one. And in the work of Orlandi et al., they resolved this problem by replacing non-malleable commitment with a special commitment scheme called mixed non-malleable commitment scheme. So mixed non-malleable commitment scheme is a commitment scheme such that it is either statistical hiding or non-malleable, depending on the parameter string. And Orlandi et al. Shows that by cleverly using it, we can obtain statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge. So however, the problem is that this mixed non-malleable commitment scheme requires a DDH assumption. And because of this, the protocol of Orlandi et al. Also requires a DDH assumption. So this is the reason why previous statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge requires a DDH assumption. All right, then to resolve this the problem of non-malleable commitment by using only one-way function, our approach is to replace non-malleable commitment with a commitment scheme called CCA secure commitment. So CCA secure commitment is a commitment scheme introduced by Canetti, Lin, Parse in 2010. So it's a commitment analog of CCA encryption. So it guarantees that the hiding property hold even when the adversary interacts with the commitment extraction oracle that receives many commitments from the adversary concurrently and returns the committed value to the adversary. So this CCA security is very strong, and in particular, it implies non-malleability. But fortunately, it was shown that this CCA secure commitment can be constructed by using only one-way function. And in addition, it was known that many of the one-way function-based CCA secure commitment also satisfies concurrent extractability. And in my work, I use this concurrent extractability. All right, so given CCA secure commitment, I designed my scheme in this way. So it is a very simplified version. So in this scheme, the first verifier commit to trapdoor information by using CCA secure commitment. And after that, the prover gave a statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge, proving that X is in L, or I know the trapdoor information. And here I know that since both CCA secure commitment and the statistical witness indistinguishable argument of knowledge can be constructed from one-way function, this scheme can be constructed from one-way function. And in this scheme, statistical simulatability is easy to prove. So in particular, since, as I said, CCA secure commitment is also concurrently extractable, the simulator can simulate adversary's view by simply extracting trapdoor information from CCA secure commitment by rewinding adversary, and then giving statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge by using this extracted trapdoor information. And from the security of statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge, this simulation is clearly statistically indistinguishable from the real view of the adversary. And the hard part of the proof is a proof of witness extractability. So we have to show that the simulator can extract witness from the adversary in the simulated view of the adversary. And to prove this, I show a lemma that states that witness is extractable from statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge in the right interaction, even when the adversary receives simulated proof in the left interaction. And to prove this lemma, I first observed that since the statement proven in the statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge is X is in L, or I know the trapdoor information, if I can show that the trapdoor information is hidden from the adversary in the right interaction, then I can use the argumentable knowledge property of the statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge to conclude that the witness is extractable from statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge. So what I have to show is that the trapdoor information is hidden from the adversary in the right interaction. So however, the problem is that we have to show that the trapdoor information is hidden from the adversary in the right interaction, even when the adversary receives simulated proof in the left interaction. So recall that simulated proof are generated by extracting trapdoor information from CCA secure commitment. So I have to argue that the hiding property of the CCA secure commitment in the right interaction holds even when the hiding property of the CCA secure commitment is broken in the left interaction. So because of this problem, I cannot simply use the hiding property of the CCA secure commitment to argue that the trapdoor information committed to in the non-CCA secure commitment in the right interaction is hidden from the adversary. And our solution to this problem is, of course, to use CCA security instead of the hiding property. So observe that CCA security guarantees that CCA secure commitment is hiding even when the adversary interacts with the commitment extraction oracle. And if the adversary can access to the commitment extraction oracle, then the adversary can generate a simulated left proof, by itself efficiently by using by obtaining trapdoor information from the commitment extraction oracle. So Z2 implies that even when the adversary receives simulated proof in the left interaction, CCA security guarantees that CCA secure commitment in the left interaction, in the right interaction, is hiding. And so even when, in this case, the trapdoor information is hidden from the adversary. And in this case, as I said, we can use the we can use the extractability of statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge to conclude that the witness is extractable from statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge. So this is a very rough sketch of the proof of witness extractability. So finally, I know that there are some technicality, and because of them, the actual protocol are more complex. So for example, in the actual security proof, I have to deal with the problem or that the security of CCA secure commitment may be damaged by the extraction from statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge. So in other words, the problem is that since statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge is ruined during the extraction, and since the adversary participated in the right and the left interaction simultaneously, CCA secure commitment in the left interaction are also ruined during the extraction from statistical witness indistinguishable argument knowledge. And because of this rewinding, CCA security do not necessarily hold. And to avoid this problem, in our actual protocol, instead of using CCA secure commitment in a modular way, I directly use the building blocks of existing CCA secure commitment. And in our actual security proof, I directly use the proof technique of existing CCA secure commitment. But I don't have time to talk the detail of this. So please see the paper. So yeah, this is the conclusion. So I constructed the statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge from argument for NP from one-way function. And this weakens the assumption needed for statistical concurrent non-malleable zero knowledge from DDH assumption to one-way function. And I don't talk in this talk, the random complexity can also be reduced to logarithmic if we assume the collision resistant hash function. All right, so thanks for listening.